Hello students, good afternoon. Today we will see our unit 15, simple future tense. Okay, today we will see only unit 15. Tomorrow we will see our last unit, that is unit 16 of the syllabus. Okay, so what do you mean by future? Future means you are talking about things that not happened yet, right?
Those are going to happen,
right? Like school is probably going to open. School still it is not open, correct? But it is going to open, correct? So that is the future. So how we are going to do represent that form with the help of simple future tense. Okay, so let's see what it is inside the chapter. So here we use the simple future tense to talk about an action or event that has not yet happened, but it is likely to happen sometime from now, right? So I have already told you that going to happen or likely to happen in a future sometime. Talk about an action or event that has not happened yet. I already told you, thing is not happened yet, it is about to happen or likely to happen. I have given example also about school. School might get open in the future, right? In a corona crisis it is closed, but in future it may open. That's what we are thinking, correct? So that we can represent in a simple future tense. Okay, so let's see here what is written. We use will or shall with the base form of the verb. This is very important. You need to understand how we can form the simple future tense, that will or shall plus we will write base form of the verb in the simple future. If we want to represent the simple future tense, how we will do? We will write subject, then will or shall, anyone. Okay, we will see with what we should write will or with what we should write shall. Plus, after that we will write base form of the verb to represent the simple future tense. Okay, so let me show you the example here. Anjali will play with you in evening. Okay, so Anjali is our subject, you is our object, and will play is our verb, right? So here you see we have used will, then we have wrote play, correct? What you have done? We have used the will, then we have used verb in a base form, that is a play, correct? So you can understand here how we can form. Anjali is not playing now, she will play in the evening, that's what we are indicating here. So Anjali will play with you in the evening. So here will and play, right? So we have wrote will and this base form of the verb, that is a play. So this way we can form the simple future tense. Okay, see the second example. Karan will eat his lunch later, right? So currently Karan is eating the lunch? No, he will eat after few hours, That's what it indicates. So here, will then plus base form of the verb. Only we have wrote in the place of verb which shows the action. So Karan will eat his lunch later. Okay. Then you will see. We also use a simple future tense to express willingness to do something. Right? Willingness means, suppose you want to do your homework. You are willing to do your homework that you wish. So that time also we'll use simple future. She will work hard for her exam. So she herself is willing to do that thing, right? She wants to work hard for herself. So that means she will work. What it is? Will work. Will work. So here, will we wrote, then we wrote verb. Correct. We shall win the match. Shall, then win. Correct. So this way, we can create the simple future tense. Okay. Okay, students, let's see further. What it say? Will or shall? Which one we need to use? I already told you, you might be confused about it. So here, we generally use shall with I and we. Whenever our subject is I or we, that time we will use shall. And whenever he, she, it, they, and you or singular or plural noun is there, that time we will use will. Okay. So understood here? Whenever I or we is there, we will use shall. He, she, it, they, you or singular plural noun is there, we will use will. Correct. You can see for I shall, we shall, he will, she will, it will, they will, you will, and verb in a base form, right? So that way we can create the simple future tense. Okay, so let's see some exercise. So forget about the answer that you have seen here. Okay, suppose I am hiding the answer for now. Okay, you don't know the answer. So what it says? Take the sentences that you are in the simple future tense and cross out the ones that are not. So what we need to do here? That here we got our 8 sentences. So out of this 8, whichever is in a future tense, simple future tense, that we need to mark correct sign. And whichever is in a, it is not in a simple future tense, that when, which, that we need to cross mark. Okay. So read the first sentence. I will go to the market tomorrow. The first thing we know here, that what we know here, that whenever simple future tense is there, our verb will be will plus verb. So this one is there, I will. So this one is the correct. Right? So now let's see other one. Dilip takes a nap in afternoon every day. So here will is not there. So we cannot say this is a simple future tense. Correct. So this has to be wrong. Yes, this is the correct answer. Right. Let's see third one. The baby is adorable. Right. So this baby you see here is adorable. But that is a natural, what we can say, universal truth that baby is adorable. We cannot change that thing. Also, it is generally we are showing what looks like a baby. So it is not a future tense, right? So that is also wrong. Now, if you see the fourth sentence, that our school will reopen in first place. So school will reopen, right? So it will happen. It is not happened yet. It will in a future. So that means this sentence is a simple future tense. So this is the correct answer. Now if you see fifth one, they collected a lot of money for the charity. So they collected a lot of money for charity. So this is not a future tense. So this is wrong. I will show you remaining answer later. Okay. Lakshman will play cricket tomorrow morning. So will play, right? It shows the simple future tense. So this one is the correct one. Grandfather will read out story to us after dinner. So what can be the answer? So will read. So this is also the simple future tense. Honesty is the best policy. So this is a universal truth and it is written in a simple tense. So it is a wrong. It is not a simple future tense, right? So this way we can identify it, right? So let's see the answer. Yes, see, this one is wrong, then correct, and last one also wrong. Let's see further exercise. What it is that rewrite these sentences using simple future tense. Don't see the answer now. What we need to do, one sentence is given. We need to rewrite it. We need to write it again and in a simple future tense. So how we can do that? I sleep in the afternoon. Right, this is a regular duty you do, but you want to sleep in the afternoon, that you want to show the future. So what you will write, what is the verb here? That sleeping is the verb, that you action do. So sleep is the verb. So in the place of verb, what you will write? Will and base form of the verb. So will sleep, remaining part as it is. I will sleep in the afternoon. If you see the second one, the dog follows its master home. So what dog is doing? Follow, right? So that is the verb. So in the place of verb, what will write? We will write will. We will write shall also, but if I and we is there here, with I we can use will also. That is also fine. Okay. So the dog will and the follows main form is the follow its master, right? It is very easy. If you see, I clean my room after lunch, so clean. Right? That is our verb. So I, after that we write will and verb, clean. Remaining thing is same, it is. Our teacher arranged a bus for the class visit to museum. So what has happened here? Arranged, right? So that is in a second form. That is in a simple past form of the verb. So in the place of that, what we will write? We will write will, our teacher will, and a base form of that is the arrange. So our teacher will arrange a bus for the class visit to the museum. You see, it looks very easy. Nothing is there. On the place of verb, we are just writing will and main form of the verb, as we discussed in a theory part. Correct? My parents took us for a holiday to Goa this year. So took, that is the verb. Correct. Took is the verb. So took is the second form of the take. So my parents will. Then we'll write in the base form of a took, that is a take us for a holiday to Goa this year. Correct. It is very easy. Let's see the sixth one. I made a card for my parents' anniversary. What you made? Made, right? You have done made. So made is the second form of the make. in the place of verb, we will write will, and base form of the verb, that is a make. A card for my parents' anniversary. Remaining part will be as it is. You can say it is very easy, right? The children put up the tents at the campsite. Right? Put up, that is the verb. So the children will put up the tents at the campsite. Correct? You can see it is very easy, not at all difficult. Right, students? Yeah. Let's see further that all of us dressed up for the fancy dress competition. So you already dressed. So dressed is, that is the verb. So all of us, then we will write will, and dressed a base form, that is a dress. Will up for fancy dress competition, that is the answer. So you can see here, it is very easy, right? We just change our verb. Nothing else is required to create a simple future tense. Okay, student, only we need to focus on that shall will plus our verb, that will be the correct one. Okay, shall we go for further? Okay, so let's go further. That is exercise our C. What it says, don't see the answer, I will explain all the answer. What it says that you have a holiday on Saturday. Suppose you have a holiday on Saturday, write down any 8 things that you plan to do that day. So suppose you have holiday, and what you will plan to do on that holiday? Suppose tomorrow is holiday, suppose, okay, it is not. So today before leaving the school, you will think, tomorrow I will do this thing, tomorrow I will do this thing, tomorrow I will play cricket, tomorrow I will watch a TV, tomorrow I will do homework, tomorrow I will add a breakfast. Right? So you will plan all the things. Correct? So that thing you need to write down. Whatever. See, here I wrote in my way. If you find, if you are doing other thing, you can write that. Okay. You can see. I will wake up early and go for jogging. Okay. I will wake up early and I will go for and go jogging. So what I will do in the morning? I will wake up and I will go for jogging. That I wrote in a simple future tense. What next I will do? Next, I will add a breakfast. So how we can write? I will help mother make breakfast. So I will help my mother to make a breakfast. Then you will go for shopping with your mother. So I will go for shopping. I will go shopping with mother. Then suppose you are cleaning your room. Then what you can write? I will clean my room after lunch. Then suppose you are going to fly a kite. So you can write that I will go kite flying with my cousins or with my friends. Whatever you like, you can write. And what you will do for that evening? So in the evening, I will go to see movie with my family. So sir, you might be going to watch a movie. So you can write here that I will go to see movie with my family. Then suppose 7. What next you will do? Sir, I will finish all homework before going for the party. Suppose there is a party. So before going to the party, going to that party, you will finish your homework. So I will finish all my homework before going to the party. We will go to the Chinese restaurant for dinner. We will go to a Chinese restaurant for a dinner. So these are the activities I will do in holiday Saturday. That's I wrote in my way. You can write if you find other works you are doing. Okay, that also you can write here. So what I did here, you see here, will wake, will help, will go, will clean, will go, will finish, will go. You see, I have wrote only shall will plus our base form of the verb. That only I wrote, nothing else. Subject plus will, shall will plus our verb in a base form, then our object. That much easy is the simple future tense. Okay, student. So here we have finished our unit 15, simple future tense. So let's revise that. To show future action, we will use simple future tense. We will use will or shall to show that. So how we can form the sentence that shall will plus our base form of the verb. That way we form it. Then where to use will and where to use shall. So with I and we will use shall. Remaining all, we will use he, she, it, they, you. With that, we will use will. With I and we also, we can use will also. Okay. Then we have seen the exercise that we have tick mark the future tense sentences and cross mark the which are not in a future tense. After that, we have seen how to rewrite the all other what we can say in a sentences in a future tense, simple future tense, right? Only we think we have done here, that is we have changed our verb to will plus base form of the verb, correct? After that, we have seen lastly that if suppose Saturday there is a holiday, so what you can do on that day, what you will do, that we have wrote here. Okay, so in a homework you need to write down this full exercise in your notebook, right? When school will start, you have to submit it. Also, be prepared for our SAM 1 exam. Okay, all unit 1 to 16 will be there. I will ask from the exercise only. No, do not worry about that. Our paper will be made up of exercise only. So be ready to prepare the exercise. Okay, so we will discuss our last chapter in a tomorrow class. Okay, thank you.